All right, now that we have a file that has animations, you can see I can click play. It'll animate how I want. I also have two scenes, scene one, scene two. And you can see my animation playing right now. After you've done your materials, you can go through and now we can export an animation inside the Twilight Renderer with using Sketchy Physics playing. What you're going to be looking for is we're going to go to Plugins, it's up at the top, Twilight version 2, and we're going to go to the Animation Editor. Inside this window, we can pick the size right here of our export, which I would suggest something like 400 by 300. And for a simple animation, we can use the low plus, that'll be adequate. And what we can do then is we need to figure out how long we need to export. So I'm going to go back into this side and I'm going to play my animation and I'm looking, move this window out of the way, I'm going to be looking down here at the bottom for how many frames are being played. So I click here and you can see down here at the bottom the amount of frames that are being played. And I'm going to watch for when my last movement really is. And I can see now I just got a little bit of movement, a few of these balls still falling. And whenever I want it to end, I see right now I'm nearing 500. I would say right around now, which I'm at 580, roughly, that would be fine to end it. So I'm going to open back up my window. And here under Advanced, I'm going to tell it how long to go. So if I put in 6 seconds, excuse me, you can see it's 181 frames. I'm going to need much more than that. In 10 seconds, only 300. In 20 seconds is 601. 25 seconds is 751. That would be more than long enough. I can also see that where it's going to save it, where it says base image name, I'm going to change the folder. So I click the arrow that goes down, click a new folder, and I'm going to change mine to my folder that's in the 7th grade tech. So I'm going to do brand new folder. And then I will give it a name and click save. I'm going to click advanced again. I'm going to make sure that it says Sketchy Physics is running Sketchy Physics. Make sure it doesn't say none like that. You want it to say Sketchy Physics. And you can make sure this reuse lighting information is in there. And right now it looks like I have everything set. So you can click the play button. And you can watch it starting to render. So you can see I'm getting my preview. And then right here it's one of 751. So we're going to see how long this takes. I'm going to render 751 frames. And we're going to see how long one frame takes. One frame is going to take just a minute. Now I'm on frame two. So this is going to take quite a while to render. But what it's doing is it's saving all those images. And I can show you in my folder. If I go into my 7th grade tech folder. You can see I'm starting to gather the images, so it's adding them. So it's saving these as just image files, and what it's going to do in the next video, I'm going to show you how to stitch all those images together to make one video. So we'll let that run, and we'll be back in the next video.